Now we are in the process of doing quadratic equation, sir. Let us go to the next question, question number 12. Question number 12 of exercise 2F. If P is not equal to Q and P square is equal to 5P minus 3 and Q square is equal to 5Q minus 3. Q square is equal to 5Q minus 3. Then find the equation. Then find the equation whose roots are P by Q and Q by P. This is our next question, sir. What is given in the question? P and Q are not equal. They are different values. Then P square is equal to 5P minus 3. One relation is given. Q square is equal to 5Q minus 3. Another relation is given. Now look at the solution part first. P square is equal to 5P minus 3. So you can also write this as P square minus 5P plus 3 equal to 0. Q square is equal to 5Q minus 3. Q square minus 5Q plus 3 equal to 0. Now you can notice one thing, sir. These two equations are same in fact. Let us see. Let x square minus 5x plus 3 equal to 0 be the quadratic equation. Be the quadratic equation. Then in this equation, if x is replaced with p, I am getting the first equation. When x is replaced with q, you are getting the second equation, sir. Implies p comma q are the roots of p comma q are the roots of x square minus 5x plus 3 equal to 0. Okay, whenever we know the roots, we can proceed for sum of the roots and product of the roots. So let us calculate sum of the roots is equal to p plus q minus of x coefficient divided by x square coefficient. Product of the roots. Is equal to pq. Constant term divided by x square coefficient, this is 3. Now, sir, p plus q, p minus q, sorry, p plus q and pq values are calculated. Look at the question, what is required? You want a quadratic equation whose roots are given. When roots are given, comma, required quadratic equation is x square minus x into sum of the roots plus product of the roots is equal to 0. X square minus x into sum of the roots plus product of the roots is 0. So this is x square minus x into p by q plus q by p plus p by q into q by p is equal to 0. Now, x square minus x into p square plus q square by pq plus 1 equal to 0. Now, what is required here, sir? P square plus q square value we need. P square plus q square is p plus q whole square minus 2pq. P plus q whole square is equal to 5 square minus 2 into 3, 25 minus 6, 19. So, x square minus x into 19, p square plus q square can be replaced with 19. We can also replace pq with 3. So, divided by 3 plus 1 equal to 0. Multiplying with 3. This is the required quadratic equation. This is your option A. This is your option A. Very simple question, sir. Now look at the question number 13. Question number 13. Let us see question number 13. If one root of the quadratic equation (5x² plus 13x) plus p equal to 0 be reciprocal to the other, then the value of p is, equal to question mark. This is my question, sir. We know one root of a quadratic equation is reciprocal to the other when x square coefficient is equal to constant term, what is x square coefficient in the given question? 5. What is constant here? P. So 5 is equal to P is the solution to the given question. Okay, we know one root of a quadratic equation is reciprocal to the other when x square coefficient is equal to constant. So 5 is equal to p. So with this, your 2F exercise is over, sir. Now I am moving to exercise 2G. Exercise 2G. Question number 1. A solution of the quadratic equation A plus B minus 2C into X square plus 2A minus B minus c into x plus c plus a minus 2b is equal to 0 is. Solution means what, sir? The value of x which will satisfy the given equation is called its solution. Again, I am repeating, solution means any value of x which will satisfy the given equation is solution. Let us see from options. When x is equal to 1, this is from options. A plus b minus 2c plus 2a minus b minus c, c plus a minus 2b, a plus 2a, 3a plus a, 4a, b plus b minus b cancel, plus c minus c cancel. Okay, sir, 4a. What left over, sir? Minus 2c, minus 2b. This is not equal to 0. therefore x is equal to 1 is not a solution. When x is equal to minus 1, a plus b minus 2c into minus 1 whole square, 2a minus b minus c into minus 1, c plus a minus 2b. Let us open the bracket, sir. A plus b minus 2c with minus sign, if I multiply minus 2a, a plus a 2a minus 2a, b plus b 2b minus 2b, 2c minus 2c. This is equal to 0, sir. Therefore, x is equal to minus 1 is a solution. X is equal to minus 1 is a solution to the given question. You can also verify x is equal to 2 minus 2. But only a solution means one value only asked, that is what we calculated here. Let us see question number 2. Question number 2. If the root of the equation x square minus 8x plus m exceeds the other, by 4, then the value of m is that we have to calculate. Let us see the terminology of the question, sir. One root exceeds the other by 4 means a difference of the roots is 4. Let alpha comma alpha plus 4 be the roots of given quadratic equation. Alpha comma alpha plus 4 be the roots of the given quadratic equation. So we can calculate sum. Alpha plus 4 is equal to minus of minus 8 minus of x coefficient divided by x square coefficient. So 2 alpha plus 4 is equal to 8. 2 alpha is 8 minus 4, this is 4. Alpha is equal to 4 by 2, this is equal to 2. Next, sir, product. Product of roots. Alpha into 4 alpha is equal to constant term by x square coefficient. But we know alpha is equal to 2. 2 into 4 into 2 is equal to m. Let me calculate the product of the roots one more time. Alpha into alpha plus 4 is equal to m. Alpha is equal to how much, sir? 2 we have calculated. 2 plus 4 is equal to m. 6 2s are 12. What is the value? M is equal to 12. Okay, now look at the solution one more time. What is given in the question? Difference of the roots is 4, or one root of the quadratic equation exceeds the other by 4. alpha comma alpha plus 4 be the roots. So you can calculate sum of the roots alpha plus 4 is 8. So 2 alpha plus 4 is 8, 2 alpha is equal to 4. Alpha is equal to 2. Now product of the roots. Alpha into alpha plus 4 is m. So I can replace alpha with 2, m is equal to 12. Look at the question number 3. The value of x. The value of x in the equation. The value of x in the equation. 7 into x plus 2p whole square plus 5p square is equal to 35px plus 117 into p square. 117 into p square. Let me take the help of options, sir. 4p comma minus 3p. Option B. 4p comma 3p. Option C. Minus 4p comma 3p. Minus 4p comma minus 3p. These are the four options. From these options we will get one hint, sir. What is that hint? If 4p is root of a quadratic equation, then minus 4p simultaneously cannot be the root. Again I am repeating this point. If 4p is one root of the equation, minus 4p cannot be the root. Because 4p minus 4p option is not there. Similarly, 3p and minus 3p option is not there. 3p minus 3p option is not there. 4p minus 4p option is not there. It means when 4p is one root of the quadratic equation, minus 4p cannot be the root. Similarly, if minus 3p is one root of the quadratic equation, then plus 3p cannot be the root. Let us verify, sir, first from options. When x is equal to 4p, 7 into 4p plus 2p whole square left hand side plus 5p square 6p, 6p whole square 36p square, 36 into 7, 252. Into p square plus 5p square, 257 into p square. Let us go for right hand side. 35p into 4p, 117 into p square. 35 into 4, 140. Into p square, 117 into p square. So 140 plus 117, 257 into p square, LHS equal to RHS. Okay, I know from the options when 4p is one solution, minus 4p cannot be the answer. So I can eliminate option B and option C from the picture. Option B and option C I can eliminate from the picture. Look at this, minus 3p plus 3 left over. First I verified with a positive value, now I am verifying with a negative value. When x is equal to minus 3p, 7 into minus 3p plus 2p whole square plus 5p square LHS. So 7p square plus 5p square, 12p square RHS. 35p into minus 3p plus 117 into p square. 35 into 3, 105, minus 105 into p square plus 117 into p square. is equal to 12 p square, sir. Once again, left hand side is equal to right hand side. Therefore, minus 3p is a solution. Same way, x is equal to 4p, also solution. So, option A is the answer to the given problem. This way, you have to use some presence of mind, sir, common sense, to identify what will be the option. Okay.